Guys, we're starting here. I just realized I wasn't recording. I need to actually double check on something. But I've got the yellow submarine set. I am building it. Bear with me one moment while I check on something. Yeah, okay, I'm sorry about that. I'll show off the box and stuff later on. I did already build the stand and John Lennon. There are 5 bags, each contains a character, the 4 Beatles and Jeremy. I start building only the very beginning of the submarine itself. I believe this is going to be the cockpit where you can sit the Beatles figures. And the part I'm at is actually only step 4. So you did not miss too much just showing off the box. Because I have no idea why I was not recording. I could have sworn I was. Alright, so this is the last part of step 4. Just had to put 4 blue square studs in. And I'm thinking any extra pieces are going to be pretty minimal on this, just due to the way they have it set up. It's really cool too. This is a LEGO idea set. Someone actually designed this and submitted it to LEGO. They did an amazing job. I will show off each of the minifigures. I'll show off John Lennon at the end of this because I screwed up, but the rest of them will be shown off as they're built. Alright, so I need 4 of these pieces, which are also used on the stand for the Beatles. Let's see. Looks like they go like this. See if I'm right. And they do have the instructions set up that it's 1 bag equals 1 part of the build, thankfully. And I need this piece here, so yes, I did build it correctly. Alright, now it looks like I need more of the yellow orange pieces, I think. Yep, yellow orange, okay. So this piece first. And does it matter the side? Yes, it does. Okay. So it's on this side. Then I need 4 of these. Try and show these off the best I can. And I'm sorry I don't have a real camera. I'm going to figure out what's going on with that shadowing issue too. I don't know why that keeps happening. Let's see. Also, I will likely put something in front of this video, so the I didn't realize I wasn't recording, it might not make some sense to some of you. Until you see that this part, obviously. There we go, part of the sub built on the bottom there. Step 7. Requires a long red piece, which I've got here. Goes on the bottom here. Okay. I was trying to put it where there's not a place to put it. Now I get to some actual yellow pieces. the same type as the yellow orange ones, but just a real bright yellow. Looks like I need 8 of them, 4 on each side. Oh, excuse me. Had jalapeno sausage for lunch and still have jalapeno burps right now. Sorry, I watched Markiplier and live streaming on, I guess it was Sunday, and I still have his Nasapipo thing in my head just because he fell so in love with that weird puppet thing. Okay, there we go. So, it actually probably didn't matter by the looks. Oh no, it'll matter because of the rotor. That's why it matters. Okay, so another one of these red pieces. And then another one of the 2x1 orange, yellow orange. Okay, that was step 8, step 9. Okay. So now it's 16 yellow orange pieces, 8 on each side. Yeah, that. I don't know why it's doing that. I'll check my camera settings, see if I can fix that. Can already see this as the submarine. I've only got what is the barest of bare there. Whoever designed this, great job. I'm sure it says in the booklet, which I will check later. The booklet has some interesting information about how the movie came about. Mentions that the makers of the American cartoon series actually went to the Beatles for it. What I find interesting is that, from what I understand, the Beatles actually didn't care for that series. It's interesting that they agreed to do this. I guess they had more control, maybe. And here's the area where I'm gonna be wanting to have my brick separator if I screw up. Two more of those. Let's be sure. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I see what I did wrong. And that is why I have the brick separator. Hopefully I can actually get this. Okay, yeah. I have to undo a bit of work, but I can get it. And by the way, I'm using the box itself, which I will be showing later, to hold the pieces as I am building. Yeah, I only put 3 on each side. That's why it didn't work, right? Okay, let's see. Here you go. There's that yellow piece for that side. And unfortunately, I do have to do it each of these pieces, so I can't just get 2. 2-1, just due to the nature of it. Whatever reason, this side is coming apart easier than the other one. Don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing. Where's that yellow piece? There you are. Would help if I put it in the right way. Right, now I can put the eight of these on each side. Knew something looked off, but I couldn't figure out what it was. Yeah, that right. Yeah, this time I have it right. I'm just putting in bad. Okay. This looks so amazing. I love it. Don't know what it is with me and these pieces. It's these bottom pieces that I'm having issues with. I have no idea why I'm having the issues. Anyways, this was a build I've been saving to a video for a while, because I'd gone to Camp Rush a couple weeks ago and got this at the Lego store. Or rather, my mom got it for me. And I just thought the colors worked out well for a Thanksgiving build. So I'm building now to make a nice centerpiece. This is also probably the first time I've been smart and actually put the pieces in a box while building. I have a bad habit of just laying them out on a carpeted floor, and you know how Legos are. I'm sorry, Lego bricks. Because I know someone's going to yell at me for that. Okay, step 9 done. So we flip it back around. And it looks like we're starting to build the sides. Okay, so two green pieces here. And it says two of these on the side, and I'm sure it's probably two put on the other side. It's probably the next step. It is not the next step, I am wrong. Okay, so I need two of these. May remember these pieces from the Agrabah set. And two of these red pieces, which I've never seen in anything before. I don't know if they were made specially for this or what, but I've definitely never seen it. In any case, the sides are meant to match up. So, there you go. Here's the other one. What side of this ship is that anyway? Yeah, okay, that's the front for sure. So, it looks like it goes like this. So that's what we got so far. And I built that wrong. It's supposed to be like that. Okay, so we have a little miniaturized section next that then will be attached to it. This blue piece here. I have no idea why my voice suddenly got higher. Right, so this and a pink piece. I also love this because it gives more use to the light colored pieces, which do not get nearly enough use. Okay, so we have that there. That was 12 and 13. Let's see. Prove these red ones again. This is a flat red, so I'm glad I had the brick separator. And then we have this piece. So I think this is going to be where the rotor's going to end up. Long red piece. Okay, got that. You can already see it coming together as a submarine. I love it. It's a relatively simple build too, which is definitely a plus. There's a flat yellow piece that gets put there, so yeah, I'm 90% sure this is going to end up being where the rotor attaches to. Let's see. Alright, so the red piece here, big red piece. Blue piece inside of that yellow piece, so might be wrong on the rotor thing now that I'm looking at it. Let's see. And then this yellow piece goes right there. Flip it around. For some reason, I got SpongeBob's Bring It Around Town thing stuck in my head. So I'll have to look up to see if they ever did anything with SpongeBob and the Yellow Submarine, because that would be a fun one. And SpongeBob likes their references, so definitely something to look up later. Alright, so this miniature piece is done. Okay, bring it back here. It looks like I have no idea how this thing attaches. Up there we go, figured it out. Okay, got it. So that's that part finished. Still more to do in this bag, though. I've never seen a piece like this before. I'm curious, are there other sets like that have pieces like this? Because I've never seen it. I have two of these pieces in this first bag. It looks like it goes up right here. So it's kind of funny because at work today they were playing Eleanor Rigby, or is the song called Eleanor Rigby? I can't remember. I think it is, but that's like the opening song for the Yellow Submarine movie. So it's just not funny that that happened out that way. All right, so the last of these pieces in the box actually goes on the back here. I mean, in the box at the moment. Again, I'm separating the bags by putting them into the box and doing each section at a time. Then we need two of these pieces that go to the sides here. I can already see this coming together. I love it so much. I know I said this so much, but it's just so cool. So I sound like Mark and his space fetish. Okay. In this next part, I'm actually having trouble seeing how to. Oh, I get it. Okay. Never mind. Right, so two more of these pieces, which are going on top of those light blue square studs. And then one on the other side. Oh, excuse me. Then this piece, which goes right here. I'm coming up on the end of the first bag, it looks like. I have another little miniaturized piece to build. This one, an actual miniaturized piece. Okay, so this orange, this blue, dark blue. These two curving pieces on top. Another one of the orange pieces to hold it together. And this attaches right here. Okay. So that's what we got so far. Okay, so now we put those orange quarter sphere pieces onto the other side. Definitely have to be very careful looking at which side I'm doing the way this is designed. Okay. Now you're actually seeing this slightly backwards from me because I'm going by the instruction booklet. And you're seeing me build, so obviously it's a bit of a different view. Okay, so the 3x2 oranges go right on top here, it looks like. Yeah, they line up with the blue piece. Not that I think there's any other way you could actually do it, but I want to be sure. All right, step 27, the last two pieces we can actually use, that we actually use from this bag, and it turns out there are two extra pieces from bag one. So we have another one of these ZS pieces, I don't know what to call them, goes right there, and a red piece that goes right in there. So, from bag one, two pieces left. And those are the only pieces left there. We have the bases of a submarine bill. And we have the Stand and John Lennon built, and let's get a better look at John Lennon. But before that, the Stand, by the way, has a hinge, so you can move the sign up and down however much you want. The book does show it slightly slanted like that. The Beatles do have two faces, what appears to be a mouth closed and a mouth open face. I have mouth open because of the goofy look. It fits the aesthetic. We have the, I'm still not sure if that's part of the jacket or not, the purple and green, but we've got the top and the split-colored leg, split-colored pantsuit combo. And what is either a telescope or a horn instrument? I'm not sure. But that that's done. I said I was going to show the box. By the way, there's 553 pieces in this. So, there's the front of the box. You can see you've got John, Paul, George, Ringo, and Jeremy all there. Or rather, Jeremy S. Boob, PhD, I believe. And, this box is designed to be able to be used as a display. On the other side, you can see the full build. You can see that the Beatles will fit into the cockpit that I'm pretty sure I just built. Built the basics of, anyway. And that they'll that there's a stand that will put the submarine as floating above the nowhere land. There is a tear there because of the way the box opens, but doesn't matter because if you're displaying, you're going to be displaying this side anyway. One side shows John and Paul, the other side shows George and Ringo. And they show different views of the submarine, basically. No, same view. No, it's just to show off the animated characters. Okay. You can see the ocean bottom there. For those who can't remember which one's which from the animation, you do have this on the top here. And something fun I noticed on the inside of the box, you have portholes. One with the Lego versions, and one with the animated versions. One thing that does disappoint me a tiny little bit is, you don't get Ringo's nose on the Lego version. Okay, so I'm going to pause here and start again with bag two. All right, here we go, bag two. First thing we have to do with bag two is build Paul McCartney. Looks like for him, all the pieces are actually already out of the bag. That makes things easier on me. For John, they were separated. Which I think had to do with his horn or whatever it is. Alright, so again, split colored pants. Shirt and psychedelic tie. Yeah, so it's a closed mouth, open mouth for sure then. And again, open mouth fits better for me. And of course, we have the mop top. And there is one more piece for him. Let's see, where is it? Right there. It have to be the piece I was touching. We have the sign for Love Is All You Need. That he's supposed to be able to hold. Does he hold it? He actually holds it well. I am surprised. Usually they do not hold these things too well. There we go, Paul McCartney. And let's see here. Yep, pause space right on here. Let's lift the sign and move it a bit. May need to rotate his hand around. Yeah, that looks better. Okay, so you may need to rotate his hand around if you have this set, because that makes it more even with the love sign. And back to building the submarine. Okay, looks like I need to open up this small bag here. Thankfully, not too much I actually have to do on this. So, 8 of these pieces, 4 of these pieces. Basically building 4 structural pieces. There's one. Two, and I forgot to change my video setting. I will quickly do that. Okay. I know it just got dim there, but that should prevent the whole flashing dimness thing from happening, hopefully. Three. Oh, excuse me again. And 4. Okay, so now these actually attach in the corners of the submarine. So they go like this. Sorry, I'm like holding multiple at once. It's kind of awkward. Yeah, so I think this is what's going to be allowing us to lift the top off. Not 100% on that, but I think it might be. I'd like to think that was back in his rotor. I've got no idea. I'm so turned around on this. I tell it's the yellow submarine. It's clearly the yellow submarine. Just look at it. But, yeah. Okay, so 10 of the drill pieces, these little things, I call them drill pieces because that's what they look like to me. Okay, and they just go right on the insides there. Four. Five. Don't know why my head's itchy right now. Okay. There's the rest of them. Okay. This is actually a really fun build too. Sometimes builds can be really cool but aren't fun to build. This one is both cool and fun. Definitely a plus. Box almost fell. I almost lost the pieces on a carpet floor. Not good. Okay, so that's that step. Okay, another section of building a mini piece. I need this. Pink radar beacon, it looks like. And orange, I'm just going to call it a target. So this will go with that part on the inside. Now we have another one of these blue pieces that goes right here. Two of these white squares, which are going to be a pain to get in here, I can already tell. Oh, yeah, pain. Okay, there's one of them. It'll make the next part easier. And there we go. Then it's six of these pieces. So these are definitely the pieces the wheels are going to be sitting on if you put them in the sub. Where I'm interchanging ship and sub, which is technically incorrect, but everybody calls subs ships anyway, so. one more of those. And no, that's not it. You're in here somewhere. I know you are. Oh, wait, I do have all six there. I'm an idiot. So we have a wheel. And the captain's chair. By the way, I'm a little bit disappointed that we don't get Sergeant Pepper and the Big Blue Meanie. But I can completely understand why we don't. This is a $60 set for a reason. All right, so building the other side here now. Looks like here and here. And we have another one of those little displays. Ooh, transparent. Oh, it wasn't transparent, was it? Oh. Okay, so we have a transparent pink piece here. And I'm going to try to match as best I can. It's not going to be perfect, because I know I'm not going to be able to get it perfect. And let's see if I can't rotate that a bit. Okay, not perfect, but pretty darn close. Okay. You guys told me no, I'm preparing it too, so I don't know why I'm doing that, but. And there should be a looks like a transparent blue piece. Okay, it's not transparent, it's just the way it looks on the thing. Okay, so this piece here. Okay, those are all identical. I just wanted to be sure. And again, this part is going on the inside. And I forgot a step. Put this right here. Okay, so what we've got so far. Definitely a fun build. Now we start building out the sides, it looks like. Okay, so these long yellow pieces go like this. Yeah, they do. Okay, they are just on top of the green there. I just wanted to be double check on that. And then we have these two kind of long purple pieces, which go fit right in between there. Come on, you can do it. I was wondering when it was going to be this part of it. It's always a part where you're trying to get pieces on and they don't quite want to fit together. There we go. Oh, a little miniature build section. Ah, I see. Okay. Not what I was expecting. Right, so this. Then this here. Not really a good way to show this off, unfortunately. And then do it again. I really need to watch the Elsa Marine again. It's been way too long since I have. So these are going on the sides like this. So now I know for sure front of the ship, back of the ship. And really, we're the side that was behaving too. Come on. That's better. You can really see it coming together. I love it. Right, now we're doing what is essentially the same thing on a larger scale. Taking a big yellow piece like this. Those two smaller pieces with a little slider. Attach them like this. And do it again. There you are. I'm also glad there's probably not any black pieces in here, or at least if there are, not much. Because it is a black box inside. Alright, and you can probably guess, but they go like this. I definitely plan to give a review of this set when I'm done because it's the Beatles and I just want to give a review no matter what. Funny story, my first introduction to the Beatles was for Christmas one year. My mom got me Looney Tunes Sing the Beatles, which, if you could find it, I highly recommend. It is a great introduction to it. They even have a little made-up story for the Looney Tunes, how they got together and everything too. It's really fun. So as you can see, we put a long piece on the sides. Come on. There we go. Now I'm going more of those orange pieces. Though on a slightly smaller scale, actually. Doing this six times. One. two. Three. Four. Five. And six. One thing I double checked the instructions is I was going to put that on wrong. Okay. So, put two here. Leave a space and put one here. Of course, same thing on the other side. Oh wow, is this coming together? We're going to do the exact same thing, except this time with yellow and only two of them. And they fit right into those spaces. Avoid more of these. Okay. All right, so we have another one of these goes right next to what I'm going to call a pipe for now. Another one of the little radar-y things, which goes right next to that. Okay. Am I even. Okay, better than I expected. Then two of these blue square studs on either side of the red, or rather, on either side of the gray Z piece. I've never seen pieces like that before, so I'm just going to call them Z pieces for now. And two of these, or rather one of these and one of these. Similar, but not the same. And yes, I did grab the right ones. Okay. Right, I did not grab two of the same ones, which I thought I did at first. Okay, so that's an easy part. So, person who did the ideas definitely used certain pieces just to make sure you know they're not going to be on the outside. Like those green pieces that I attached a bunch of stuff to. Okay, similar steps on the back. We have another one of the transparent ones. Okay, if you're a little crooked, but that is way too crooked. Another one of the orange target ones. And then again, two of these right next to the pipings. So you can see the parts I just built on either side there. These pieces go right in the front. Then yellow cheese wedge on either side. And that is bag two complete. Trying to show you guys the inside as best I can. Maybe turn that light on soon. Okay. So, extra pieces in bag two. One white square. One orange target. One blue purple target. One pink radar thingy. One blue square stud. One transparent piece. And one gray stud. So that's one, two, three, seven extra pieces in bag two. So I'm going to pause here, turn on that light because it's getting dark in here, and be back with bag three. Okay, for whatever reason, my computer's still doing that weird thing with the camera. I don't know why. But it is time for bag three. And I need to scooch in a bit. That's better. Now we're building George. I think might be the only one with solid color pants. No, he's not. Okay. George has black pants. What I can only assume is a smoking jacket. His head, again, there's a closed mouth and open mouth. I'm putting the open mouth smiling. And his version of the mop top. And then for his last part, I need to open this up. So I need this. And I'm not sure what piece that is. It's not very helpful. Ah, there it is. Okay, so I think this is like maybe a camera or something. Oh, I know what this is. This is the periscope thing, isn't it? Really? That's how you hold it? Okay. Oh, that actually works out very well. Maybe it is a camera. But no, it goes in the direction of his face, so unless he's vlogging, which I don't think they did in that way then. Let's face it, vlogs have been around for a long time, just not in the way that we know them now. Magical Mystery Tour is basically a giant vlog. Of course, we'll put him on his space. And we are back to working on the sub. I'm just realizing now how much of the Wahlahoggy Fest lifted, how much the Wahlahoggy Fest lifted from Yellow Submarine for their design. Like, I knew they lifted from it, was obvious, but wow. And that's actually all for the first step, just adding two little orange L pieces there. No, I'm not missing a piece. I've never missed a piece in a Lego set. So I'm obviously missing something obvious. And yes, I was. There they are. Don't know why I was sing-songing. Alright, so these go on top of the L pieces and the blue pieces. Alright, and four orange cheese wedges on each side. Go right next to the yellow ones. Wish my computer wasn't acting up. I don't even know how much of this you're even able to hear. Let's see. There's one more. Where are you? Staring right at it. Oh, and I am sorry about this blinding you. Oh, this is going to be a fun piece, I think. Okay, so one of these. Yeah, it must be red. Okay. I do wish they didn't lighten the colors to make it show the transparency. There has to be a better way to do it. But it is red. So two transparent reds. A warped clock. I remember correctly, it is a clock if it's warped. Pink at the top, okay. So it goes, hangs off a little bit. And we'll actually turn this around to show you guys how it gets put. This one goes right here. And you can see the other side there. And something similar for another. I cannot talk. Something similar for the next step. Okay, again, this piece, again, two transparent reds. Then what appears to be a pressure valve. I had to double check and make sure I had the correct side up. That must. Okay, so that goes like that. Then goes right in here. Okay, and well, it's more or less the same thing on the other side. Again, the two transparent studs. This time we use a clock piece. Are these identical? Yes, they are. Okay. And it goes. I'm going to say 10:15. It doesn't actually fit on a real time. Okay, so that's that. Now it goes right across from the warped clock. Again, this orange piece, which is actually getting a lot of use. Pieces like this don't usually get so much use. Again, two transparent reds. And the time machine thing, trying to remember what song plays during this part. Ugh. I know George is the one who starts singing it, but I can't remember off the top of my head. So that's what we've got so far. Now we have what is basically the hull of the ship. I have mispronounced that badly. Let's see. Okay, shorter part this time. Doing two of these. Where's that last part? There it is. There's one of them. There's the other. And they attach. Ah, okay, I see. They attach like this, I think. No? That doesn't look right. It's not right. They attach like this. There we go. This piece is going to be fun to mess with. Let's see. Yeah, got him. Two of these yellow ones, which go right on top of the yellow and connect the red to the yellow. And then two of these yellows with the holes, which go like this. Okay, see how this next part works. This could be a bit of a pain to do, actually. Oh, wait, no, never mind. Was thinking too much into it. Put the blue pipe thing pieces in there. Add this here. There's the snap that I was hoping for. And there we go. Another piece you don't see used too often. This one I've at least seen before on like that weird gray Z piece. And goes on top like this, it looks like. There we go. All right, two of these crosshole pieces. Which go right on top of those two pieces I just attached. Like that. Another miniaturized build. I need this. This. And another one of that. And here it is. Okay. Getting the tail of the submarine there. a square right on top. And excuse me, a through piece for that cross area. I do not have it lined up right, do I? There we go. Basically putting a nail in. Okay, what I have come to refer to as wool builders, thanks to the McFarlane sets. Red L's. Well, actually, I don't want the red L's quite yet. I want these first. And how are they attached? First, I put that piece in the wrong place. So let's fix that. Okay, you go right here. The reds go right next to you. Okay, and the L's go onto those pipings to connect. Almost lost my pieces again, that would not have been good. Okay, so there we go there. More of those white squares, fun. Well, this time they have studs on them. Next to the red rectangle there, seems to be to make things flush, as well as add some of the white to the submarine. Okay, let's see. So I need two of these pieces and happen to grab the right one, the fuzzy monitor. Okay, there we go. Get in there. I'll do that. I twist the white piece around, that's why it's not fitting. Okay. There we go, got it. Then these pieces go and hold that down. Then there's a red piece to make it flat up top. Okay, now doing with the white, let me just do with the red. So we have a slightly smaller version of those red pieces, basically. And they attach to the top of the monitor. And the flat white piece goes right on top of that. a little bit of heat coming in, so I'll unplug the computer. It's basically charged at this point anyway. Let's see. Now we add a whole lot of orange. Okay, because it's easiest for me to do it this way. There we go. Why are you easier than the white was? I wonder if there's some molding difficulty in white that makes it harder to put together on here. Okay, now orange L pieces, which again are to connect areas. One thing I can already tell, this is going to be a very sturdy build, which is good for a collector's build. One of those flat orange squares. Again, I don't know why I'm singing. Pressure gauge. Looks like, yep, it catches right, without us being in the right way, catches right there. Next step. Okay, the mint green piece goes right behind the pressure gauge. I'll do two stacks of 2x1 oranges. Attach right on top of those flat orange pieces. Okay, let's see here, what's next? This green piece in front of the mint piece. And then next to that, two of these pieces. Not much left for this bag now. It actually went quicker than I was expecting. Let's do this with the first of the larger bags. All right, this piece again. Another piece that doesn't get much use is getting a lot of use in this set. Not necessarily a bad thing. Put the light blue on top of that. And it goes right in here. Then six of these for another side. Either side, I meant to say. I don't know what word I said there, if it even was a word. Okay, so that's that part. Next up, we flatten out the top of it. I also noticed that whoever did the ideas for this minimized the number of pieces as much as they could. Something I appreciate because it does lower the price. This. So we have a dome piece here, and I was really wondering when it was going to get used. And it turns out it's now. Want to make sure I do have it lined up correctly, because that will affect a little bit, I think, but not much. Okay, I think that's correct. Find out. No, I had it right before. I think. I know it's going to attach to the front just by looking. Yeah, okay, so I want to rotate this slightly. There we go. Got the nose. The very last part for bag three. To attach these to the sides. I suspect that's the first of many porthole type pieces. So, in this bag, the extra pieces are one lens, one flat orange, one yellow, one white, one transparent red. And one clock. So again, I'm going to pause here, get the next bag ready, and then I'll be right back with you guys. Okay, bag number four. Now we get to build Ringo. Gray pants, pinstripes shirt and tie, then closed mouth and open mouth both look very happy on him. I am going with the open mouth. So I think that was the, yeah, that was the open mouth, just right there. Hard to tell with him. Okay. And then the only mop top that actually looks like their mop top. And he has what is a black gaunt, what I call a black tambourine, because I'm sure that's what it's meant to be. There we go, now you're holding it. And add him to the final space on the stand. Got him and John both have the red and yellow stripes on their sides, which is probably why they're used as the end pieces. Time to build the rotors. Just have to open the tiger bag. Okay, not quite what I was expecting from this actually. Okay, so a brown piece, two of these little yellow cross pieces. The fan for the rotor. Yep, that's the right way. Oh wait, no, it isn't. There we go. Of course, the rotor spins because it would not be any fun if it didn't. Now we built that again. See if I can find the pieces again. Okay, there we go. There we go. Forgot to count for bag three was six extra pieces. One of them surprisingly big. Also, because of something coming up, I want to put my headphones back on. Put them off when I check some things and then never put them back on. Not that it matters much for what I'm doing at the moment, but for a little bit of fun I have coming up like while I'm on. And there's the second one. And they go on to the blue pipes here. Because of course, we had the double rotors on the Beatles' Yellow Submarine. two of these are up next. I'm going to refer to these as banana boats, I think. Don't have any reason to. Just going to. Okay, so they attach. I felt something move and thought that the piece came off. No, it was I just happened to touch the rotor. All right, and these are coming back. Suspect this will finish off most of the submarine part. That's not the right color. That's the right color. Okay, and two of these again. Now, where's the other one? Right there. Nope, not right there. Right there, again, I was looking right at it. This is what always happens with Lego building. I can't find a piece, it's because I'm looking right at it. Time for a little tiny piece together. Need this, and there should be, yep, cheese wedge. Goes like this. Then do it again. I actually put it on the wrong way the first time, so it's actually like this. Easy fix. I should not need a brick separator for this part. Come on. There we go. They're being attached right here, right above the rotors. Help if I was putting it in the right way. I was putting it in the right way. Really? Well, it was bound to happen eventually, but I had a chunk come off. Oh, that's the wrong way. And happened again. Let's try holding that down. That might help. That did help. So, slider pieces, which is interesting, are on the inside. Big banana boat. This piece here. Right at the tip of the big banana boat. Again, I have no idea why I'm referring to it as that, I just am. And this is bound to make a piece come off, because it goes right here. Really? Wow, okay. I'm not going to complain. And I do realize I'm an idiot and the red pieces are the portholes. Okay, this is going to be a fun part to build. Okay, that is a six piece. And this. Yeah, it looks like it's all yellow pieces. So it's this piece then. The yellow claw. I actually have to build a piece to build on top of that piece. Let's see. Got it. So this goes here. And this goes here. Excuse me. And this is here. And then this goes right on top here. Kind of have a little horse head thing here. It's not attached to it, kind of does look like a little horse head or maybe a little dinosaur. Am aware that's actually the tail fin. Let's see. Yep, right up there. There's something wrong somewhere. Forgot a step, that's why. That step. Okay. I did that. Switch the step around. It looks like. Oh, that's right. I see what I did. Okay, that's an easy fix, which is a rare thing to say for Legos. Funny thing is, it looks really off, and I didn't even notice. No wonder I was having trouble with pieces coming off. I had them built wrong. So I was fixing the sides up top there. Okay, now I should be able to do this. Now this should have exactly enough. Yep. There we go. Ooh, this one part looks fun to build. Okay. Let's see. That's not the right piece. This is the piece I want. Okay. What pieces are hard to show? Okay. Put it on wrong again. There we go. Okay, so you can kind of see where this is going. Three teeth pieces. That feels so weird to say, but that seems to be the best portal of it. And okay, that part's built and will now attach. And now the sub has steering. He works. This reminds me of the pirate ship I had when I was a kid. This is way cooler though. Looks like we're about to finish up the back side of it. Take two glue pieces here. Yellows in front. Then the oranges. Then more oranges. Okay, so flat yellow on top of the yellows. And flat orange on top of the oranges. Flip it around. Yellow 3x1s on the bottom to hold them together. Have a strong feeling I know how this is going to attach. Yep. Finishing the back side, which may actually be for the purpose of giving Jeremy a place. And now we build the top of the submarine. This is the really iconic part of it. Orange arch, orange lengths, more porthole pieces. Four of them for eight portholes to be exact. That's one. Two. 3. And 4. And they attach pretty much how you'd expect. Orange, I don't know what to call it. Semi-ovulated, maybe? Attaches right like this. Alright, so next I build like this. Then build another one. Is that right? It doesn't feel right. Missing something. What am I missing? Ah, that's what I'm missing. I forgot a piece. There should have been another one on the bottom. Okay, let's see. Where's that last? I know you're in here. I'll be right back. I actually had built the first one correctly. Okay, so there we go. Get this box back up here. Something I forgot to show on the box is it has all we need is love. Love is all you need. Alright, so red lines attached to the bottom there. Yep, I had a feeling that's what those pieces were going before. Alright, so attach whites here. Then the arch, finish this part up, and of course it starts coming apart when I do that. Thankfully, I'm pretty sure it's going to end up being pretty solid overall. In fact, it definitely is. Put a big red piece right there. Big white piece right here. And a white semi-ovuloid right there. Okay, flat white right at the edge. Again, Again, very hard to see the light. Perfect, except my light is on now, it's reflecting. But I need the light to be able to see what I was doing. And very light blue piece. That's just right here. Gray pieces attach in front there. Okay, now building the outer edges. We have more of these pieces, which I have never seen before. Not in this scale, anyway. Okay, so the corners are pretty flush, at least for that part there. Eight of these, four on each side, the wedges out this time. One, two, three, four. So I started this a little bit after 1:30, by the way. So it's taken me a good while to build. Probably started maybe quarter of two, a little bit after that. Six. Seven. Eight. And two more of these pieces, and they do attach right at the corner there. Gotta be pretty flush. Yep, okay. Not quite flush with the corner due to where they are, but they are somewhat. Okay. I miss a piece somewhere. I don't remember using it. Oh, that's right. Okay. That was part of the tail. All right, so that's what we have at the top so far. Back four, we have one red piece. White square. A white quarter circle, very tiny. Again, I've seen the white quarter circles before, never that small. Transparent red. White rectangle. And yellow cross. Hole. For a total of one, two, six extra pieces from bag four. Oh, excuse me. So I will be back with bag five. And now we have bag number five, the final bag. all bags can contain a character. This one contains Jeremy. Whose accessory is one of the Apple Bonkers apples. Apple bombs, rather, if I remember correctly. Need to open a smaller bag for him as well. Pink piece attaches to his back that I'm not really sure what it represents. Can't remember if he has a tail or not. It's been so long since I've last seen the movie. Might be a tail. Anyways, that is Jeremy Hillary Boob, PhD. And
he's a sitting in his nowhere land, making all his nowhere plans for nobody.
Sorry, I had to. All right, back to work. I need two of these, apparently. Where is the other one? I know you're in here. Again, looking right at it. And you attach on the white side. Okay, so like this. Then green pieces attach on top of them. Make sure I have them in the right way. I'm sure I won't get copyright claimed on this, but whatever. I've been working on this so long, the mail just came. Okay. Alright, so gray keys and the two little black plug pipe pieces. Looks like they attach this way. Okay. This is why we need the pipe pieces, because we have two of these. Yellow slide whistle piece icon next. They have the little holes there on one of them. There's the snap. You can put an orange one on the other. and being very picky about what parts are visible. I really don't need to be this picky. I think this is what's going to be the periscopes. In fact, I'm certain of it. Okay. Another one of those gray pieces. Where are you? There you are. Again, those two black pieces. Why do I look evil when I'm doing this? Piece here, catch this blue one in, this attaches here, thus in there's an orange version for the other side, yes there is. And the slide whistle pieces go on to their own color. And yet, no question about these being the periscopes. Or the quadscopes. Sorry, bad joke. What if I just dropped it? Oh wait, I might actually have a better camera for recording soon. It won't be much better, but it will be better. It depends on certain factors. Okay, so there's the top so far. Now we have the iconic, what I can only call house windows. And they attach right at the sides there. And there's a pink piece that attaches on the back. There we go there. Now we're building a bit more on top of that. So we need a white frame. Two of these pieces. Where's the other one? Probably looking right at it. Yes, I am. Two more of these white flat squares. definitely in here, and there you are. And six of these studs with the holes. So I'm not sure if there's even a reason for the holes in this case, but they're there. It's pretty sure they're going to be covered up, so. Right, and this attaches around the periscopes. Come on. There we go. Bolts the little house window things in. Ah, so that's what that pink piece was for. Okay, so I need this. Then a white wedge facing this way. And it attaches right on the pink piece here. Makes everything nice and flush. Now we're working on the other side. Okay, so there is a reason for the hole pieces. We need six of these wrench pieces to go into those six white pieces. One, two, and I have them facing the wrong way again. There we go. Easy enough fix. I forgot to attach two of those white pieces. Right, there's four. And then there's three. There's four. Five. And finally, six. I need to move my instructions a bit because it's getting harder to see them. Okay. So four hot dog pieces. Which fit into the wrenches. And this might take me a bit. Comes making a ring around it. Never would have thought to use hot dog pieces like this. It works, don't get me wrong, I just never would have thought of it. I need to get you to snap in, come on. There you go. And two of them actually are kind of facing down. There you go. And the last one of these, for now at least. That is really, really nice looking. Looks like it's time to start finishing up the periscopes, starting with the yellow ones. Okay, so red, white. Attach that to this here. Put a blue piping in, and it goes like this. Oops, wrong way. Like this. Then do it again. So the red. The white. Yellow piece, blue piece. And they attach on top of the yellow. You can really see this coming together. I keep saying that, but it's so true. I love this thing. Not what is expecting the next step to be, okay. Our slide whistle and black pieces again. Where do they go into? Right on top of the oranges, so that's to lift it up a bit, I guess. Now I bet the next step is to actually make the periscope part. Yep. So red, white, orange, blue piece. And then do the exact same thing. Red. Where are you? There you are, white, orange, blue piece, and no points for guessing where these go. And of course, they can be moved. Still a bit more to do here, though. I'll see that piece. So it's on top of another piece. Okay, white square. Another one of those pink pieces. two of these. More of those quarter circle pieces. Give me a break, language is hard. Okay, there we go. I'll be right back. Sorry, computer needed to be plugged in again. All right, next step. All right, two more of these. Go right on top of the pink piece. Two of these white squares with studs. I forgot a step, but it doesn't matter. White wedge down here. This 4x1 white to hold it all together. White piece to make it flush. Then two more quarter circle pieces. So there we go. Let's build this little slope. Goes this way. And I believe, let's see if I'm right. Yes, I am. It will attach this way. Not too much left for the sub itself. Got two of these red pieces. Let's go right there. Finish it off. We have these two pieces. So right there, and to stop the studs from showing, which again you can't see due to lighting, unfortunately, we have a smaller piece there. And there is the top of the sub. Come on. Don't know why I'm having a hard time with this. There we go. Okay, so this part can lift off, and we found out that this part can lift off. So this part is for the Beatles, and this must be a hidden feature for Jeremy. It's not mentioned in the advertisement at all. The other part is, but this part is not. So you can put all five figures into it. That's the sub itself, but we are not done with this build yet. Now we have to make the nowhere land. Okay, so pink. Green. Screwed up there. What this is for. Easy enough fix. Green. Blue. Put red in those little corner spaces. I don't think it matters too much. I'm pretty sure this part's getting covered up anyway. Okay, so one big circle, two small ones. Right, so yep, I have that right. Okay, good. And this one is harder. Okay, gotcha. And basically flip it around, do the same thing. No, 100% I have that correct. Because I do not have that correct. Okay, there it is so far. Smart move using a piece with holes in them, since nowhere land does lead to the land of holes. Whether or not that was intentional, I don't know, but it's funny. So seven of these little round ones, the little round hover pieces, okay. There we go. This is actually hard to tell how this is supposed to go. Okay, let's see. So I know this. And of course, it came off. And this. And this one goes here. Pretty sure if I screw this up, it'll be very obvious once everything's put together. What's that last cover piece? I'm not sure where that last cover piece is. I'm sure it's in here. I just don't know where. Well, that might be one of the ones that didn't actually come out of the bag for whatever reason. It happens sometimes. Where is bag 5? Yeah, it's one of the ones that didn't come out of the bag for some reason. Found it. Okay, so there we go. Flip it back around. We start covering some areas. A big piece goes wrong way. Actually, having a hard time on this one. Let's see. That's right. Smaller one of those pieces. Goes here. And then this goes right here. Put a red piece here. We'll continue along. Big piece connects around here. And small piece connects like this. Not quite. Like this. Okay, and then we have a white piece going on top there. Got a little bit of, so surrounds the red stud area. Okay, starting to get easier now. All those cases where the more you get done, the easier it gets. Very, very nice Nowhere Land so far. Those pieces designed for covering up. A flat white piece. And right here. That's that blue. And we have smaller circle, it looks like. Yep, smaller circle. I'm not entirely sure from the right place. In fact, I know I didn't. That's better. Getting to the end. As I said, I started maybe around 2 o'clock the latest. It's now past 5. I'm not sure how this piece goes on. It's one of those should be obvious, but it's very unclear. It's the last circle piece I need to put on. And I'm not exactly sure how to put it on. But I think I might have accidentally just discovered it. I accidentally discovered it. Okay, there we go. There we go, Nowhere Land. Oh boy, where are these corners going? Okay, not too bad. Phew. They actually go right next to the square piece there. Funny thing is, this was not the planned video for today. This is going to be uploaded tomorrow, but just due to how much work it took, I'm uploading it tonight. Now we have two clear pieces that I believe are going to make the actual stand. And there's actually four of them. Because you put two cows there. Okay, so one goes on a small circle and one goes on a large one. The submarine goes there. Way too long to do this for you to fall. I love this. You're not quite in on one side. There you go. There's a space for Jeremy on the front. Ah, that hatch is for the storage of their items. Okay. Of course, I like my idea better of letting Jeremy ride in there. That last bag has one quarter circle white, one white square stud, one white square flat, one white circle flat. One hot dog, one wrench, one black pipe, and one red stud for a total of 8 extra pieces in the final bag. Extra pieces total. Twenty-nine extra pieces. Most of them ones I understand, a couple of big pieces that I don't. Anyways, I'm going to put all the extra pieces in the box now. That should be 31. I may have not counted two pieces. I'll leave the brick separator out because it's always useful to have a brick separator. I mean, I've got a ton of them now because this lady's got a lot more kind with them, but. Maybe 32, there's another one I may have missed. And I do have the name of the designer in the back with some information about him. So the fan designer was Kevin Zito. I hope I pronounced that correctly. That's the one who made the model for Ideas. The one who refined the model is Justin Ramsden, from the Lego Corporation. I love the Lego Ideas. They bring some amazing things. And I will definitely be doing the survey. Anyways, this was quite a build. Fun build, but long. Actually curious, can Jeremy fit into the back there? Might not actually be able to. Nope, he's just slightly too big. That's a little disappointing. But that's not what it was for. Jeremy has his own place in the Nowhere Land. Okay. How do I get you on there? There you go. Okay, so a fun build, a challenging build, both are pluses in my book. Challenging builds aren't always a plus, but in this case, I think it works. Beautiful design. I mean, just look at this thing. The theme was well thought out. Well, the transparent pieces are completely hidden. It's good enough. The way of Nowhere Land is a nice touch for a base. And Jeremy basically was part of the group for that movie. The stand is for the Beatles themselves is nice. I'm sure I'm missing some things with the items. I think this is the periscope thing, but I'm not sure. Only one I know for sure is that Ringo has a tambourine. Also, the Ringo one makes me want a Mr. Conductor set with the original Mr. Conductor. The second one's not bad either. They can all actually hold their items, which is a plus. That's not always the case. They look really nice together. The love sign is a nice touch. I definitely recommend getting this set if you are a fan of the Beatles, especially if you're a fan of the Yellow Submarine movie. Well worth it, in my opinion. So anyways, that's all for now. I have something else for tomorrow, something that I've been trying very hard to get to. And as always, thank guys for watching and have a great time wherever you may be. Bye guys!